दे रहे हैं ओनली 65 मेंबर्स
सर, इन्होंने देना निमिष सर बार सर एल
स्क्रीन विजिबल है दिया भास्कर भास्कर गौड़ा
सर
फोटो चेना क्या स्पेक्स चेना तुम्बा स्मार्ट
का
ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ನಾನು ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಕ್ಕೆ ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಹೇಳಿದ್ಕಿಮೇಲೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ. ಅಪ್ರಿಶಿಯೇಷನ್ಗೆ ಓಕೆ ವೀರೇಶ್ 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 ಹೆಸರೇನಪ್ಪ 900 ವೀರೇಶ್ ವೀರೇಶ್
ವೀರೇಶ್ ಸರ್ ಈ ಕಾಲಿಂಗ್ ವೀರೇಶ್ ಬೊರಾಡೆ.
ಹಾ ವೀರೇಶ್ 920092 ಆಬ್ಸೆಂಟ್ ನಾ ವೀರೇಶ್ ಬೊರಾಡೆ See how many are joined? 78. Hello, Viresh. Hello, Viresh. Hello, Viresh. 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 Is it audible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. ಏನಾಗಿದೆ ನಾವು ವೀರೇಶ್ ನೋಡೋದು ಏನ ಅದು ಸುಮ್ನೆ ಕೂತ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಬೇರೆ ಕಡೆ ನೋಡ್ತಾವನ ಹಲೋ ವೀರೇಶ್ ವೀರೇಶ್ Okay, now I will continue the class. Last class we have to discuss. Hello? Yeah. Just a moment. Okay, please listen. Last class we have discussed about the general aspects. Okay, what are all the soil and water conservational measures for the arable land, non-arable land, and also the drainage line? Did it clear, Dhanush? Dhanush, yeah. Dhanush. Anaga? 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 Chaitra?
Anaga, sir is calling you.
Yes, sir.
So what are you doing? Anaga, what are you doing?
Listening, sir.
No, your voice, voice is not, I called many times. You didn't reply. Okay, is it audible now? Is it audible?
Audible, sir.
Okay, thank you. So listen, just to not to switch on the mobile and keeping somewhere in the corner of a room and going around the house. Okay, please listen. So these are all the some of what we have discussed. Conservational measures are to be adopted in all three different kinds of category of a land. So one is arable land, another is the non-arable land, and third one is the whatever the drainages, gullies, nalas in the given catchment area, that is third category of it. These three category of a lands are required the different types of conservational measures. For the arable land, so just be less than the 2% of the land slope. 2% means for every 100 meter, there is a 2 meter difference in elevation between the two points. So in such a land, so not a much of the erosion problem. So anyhow, we have to take care of manipulating the soil by adapting the agronomical measures or the biological measures. And where there is a more slope, and also the based on the soil type, so based on the precipitation received or the rainfall received on that particular area, you have to select the mechanical or the engineering measures. Okay, let us study what are the conservational measures of both agronomical as well as the mechanical engineering measures, control measures are adapted in arable land. In arable land, that is in cultivated land. So one by one, I will repeat once again. I'm going very quickly. So the agronomical measures for the for the cultivated land or the arable land. First one is the contour cultivation, that is already discussed. Okay, contour cultivation. So this is the after cultivating, growing the crops, the field seems to be like this. So this is the cultivated cultivation of pattern, and this is the cultivation with the bonding vegetative bonds. So second one is ridge and furrow cultivation. So just in between the crop rows, opening a furrow. This is one. The another one is the dead furrow in the red gram, and that is intercropping system. That cropping system can be studied in the agronomy detail about the different cropping systems. Okay, the dead furrow in between the two red grams plus the the main crop as a groundnut. So that will be already I have discussed how this way this will be conserved the rain and also the soil and the water. So ragi, so are the red gram, the same other pattern. So this is the another one is strip cropping. This is another conservational measures in the arable land. So coming to the mechanical measures in the cultivated land. Mechanical measures in the cultivated land, what are the conservational measures? So that is, one is contour bond, already defined and discussed, and this contouring. So how to make the contouring for the construction of a contour bond. So then what is the size of the contour bond is required? That is, the size is nothing but the cross-sectional bond. Okay, and this is the sketches of the two contour bonds. In between these two contour bonds, how this water stagnation near the bond, how this the seepage zone and also the saturation zone is demarcated. Here somebody is chatting, so just a minute. Okay,
sir, so, can you show the previous slide?
Tell me. Hello.
Sir, can you explain this? Yes, sir. Can you explain this?
Yeah, definitely. So this is not simply one word. Just I am going give you a framework. this will take another two class. So I will explain. This is one how what this. So we have to put this. We have the different sloping range. Okay, we have the different side tanks. Okay, so in this condition, the water and also in that particular area, the rainfall is also varies. Some area receives low rainfall, some area receives higher rainfall. Based on considering all these factors, the precipitation or the rainfall and the soil type and the topography, how much water is to be checked, how much water flow is to be controlled, that has to calculate. I will explain this later. That we have taken two classes for this only. Okay, no problem.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I will tell you. So this is the size of the bund. Size of the bund, that means based on this, what is that? Based on the amount of precipitation received, if it is a high and with a higher intensity, if the soil is very low infiltration, it gives the more runoff water, or otherwise. Also the slope is too slow, so it will produce very huge quantity of the runoff water as compared to the flat land, because the velocity of the runoff is high. So considering in these factors, you have to decide which size of the contour bund is essential, which size of the contour bund is needed in that particular area. For that, that size of the bund is expressed in terms of cross section. Cross section is the nothing but the dimension of bottom width, top width and height. You have to consider after finding the volume of water runoff water from that particular area, then is decide how much height is to be there, how much width is to be provided, okay, and what is the size is required for the particular soil type, that has to be discussed. Okay, is it clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I will take another two class. I have given just one day. What is that? The framework. You have to know that what are all the conservation measures we have to adapt it for such this condition, arable land condition, non-arable condition, and also for the drainage line treatment. Then we have to study one by one at the end. So next class onwards, probably next class onwards. Okay. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. I will teach you. This is one. I will give you the framework. That's all. Just to remember, this is the photograph of your this all of the background of this course. Okay. See, this is the condition where if you are putting these two bunds in the given area, so the upper bund I already explained in the last class. That is a saturated zone and also the seepage zone. Okay, did it clear? I will explain in the later on in the future classes also. Okay, so that is which type of today you have to just to know about the which type of conservation measures in which situation, that has to know. Okay, see, the another one is graded bund. So I think graded bund is not described. Anyone last class?
No, sir, it is not described.
Yes. So I will explain. So this is graded bund. So the condition is three. I already told you for the contour bund, the purpose is full conservation of the rainwater, and also the where there is a rainfall, region receives the rainfall less than the 700 millimeter. So in that situation, if you want to go for provide the conservation or the infiltration of all the water, rain water, so contour bund is necessary. So in area, some area, we have the higher rainfall. So in the higher rainfall areas, the maximum the infiltration or the soil saturation is required certain amount of water, certain amount of depth of rainfall. So after the rain, after that saturation, what happens? The water is stagnated. If you are going for constructing this contour bund in that particular higher rainfall areas, so what happens? So there is a stagnation of water. If it is a area is stagnated by the water, the all crop will die. So that is a problem. The flooding will be occurs. So for this, for that purpose, we have to go for the adapting the other conservational come the safe disposal technique called graded bunds. Okay, anybody? Is it clear? Is it clear now? Is it clear? Where we have to adapt the graded bund. So how to define this graded bund? So here we have given three criteria. One is graded bunds are the earthen embankments. Earthen embankment, they are constructed. They are constructed across the slope. Remember, not along the contour. It is across the slope. Construction of earthen embankment across the slope. Across the slope for the conservation of rainwater as well as the safe disposal of excess water. Safe disposal of excess rainwater, that where the rainfall receives in an area about more than 700 mm. Is it clear? Anaga?
No, sir.
Didn't clear?
Yes, sir.
Didn't clear? Dev?
Yes, sir.
Dev.
No, sir.
So where there is a area receives more than the 700 mm rainfall, so in that case the need of expose the disposal of excess standing water in that plot. So for that purpose you have to provide the grade and first conserve the maximum. After saturation, the excess water, stagnated water is to be disposed of at non-erosive velocity. Is it
clear? Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes.
So, this, how to define this? I will define once again. The graded ones are the embankments, earthen embankments, which are constructed across the slope for the conservation of rainwater as well as the safe disposal of excess standing water, stagnated water near the bund by providing, if you want to safe dispose, you have to provide the providing 0.2 to 0.4% bund gradient. I will explain in the designing criteria. I will explain, okay, later on. Okay, well, how we have to provide the grade for the bund. If you are not providing the grade for a bund, the water is standing because you are putting the earthen embankment across the slope. So if you are providing the grade, so it will slowly move. There is no water is to be stagnated near the bund. Is it clear, all of you? All of you?
Yes.
Can I explain once again in local language? Just I will give you one
yes,
minute.
Sir. Yes, sir.
So, ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಮಳೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಆ ಮಳೆನಲ್ಲಿ ಮಳೆ ನೀರು ನಿಂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಕೊಳ್ತು ಬೆಳೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕೊಳ್ತು ಹೋಗೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಅಂತ ನೀರನ್ನ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೀರು ಸಂರಕ್ಷಣೆ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ನೀರು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೋಸ್ ಸೇಫ್ ಡಿಸ್ಪೋಸಲ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರನ ಮಾಡ್ತಕ್ಕಂತ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್ ಮೆಜರ್ ಏನ ನಾವು ಏನಂತೀವಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಗ್ರೇಡೆಡ್ ಬಂಡ್. ಅದನ್ನ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ 0.22 to 0.4% ಬಂಡ್ ಗ್ರೇಡಿಯಂಟ್ ಕೊಡಬೇಕು. ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರನೇ ಈ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್ ಮೆಜರ್ ನ ಅಡಾಪ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಡಿಡ್ ಯು ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು? ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗ್ರೇಡೆಡ್ ಬಂಡ್. ಹೇಳಿ ಅಯ್ಯೋ, ನೀವು ಒಂದು ಒಂದು ಜಮೀನಲ್ಲಿ ಬದು ಹಾಕಿರ್ತೀಯಲ್ಲಪ್ಪ, ಹಲೋ, ಒಂದು ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬದು ಹಾಕಿರ್ತೀಯ. ಆ ಬದು ಹಾಕಿದಾಗ ನೀರು ಮಳೆ ಬಂದಾಗ ನೀರು ಅಡ್ಡ, ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ಸ್ಲೋಪ್ಗೆ ಅಡ್ಡ ಹಾಕಿರ್ತೀಯ. ಮಳೆ ನಿಂತ್ಕೊಂಡಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಆ ನೀರ್ ಎಲ್ಲೋಗುತ್ತೆ, ಅಲ್ಲೇ ನಿಂತ್ಕೊಂಡಿರ್ತದೆ. ಆ ಜಮೀನಲ್ಲ ನಿಂತಿದ್ದಾಗ ಆ ನೀರನ್ನ ಹಾಗೆ ಕಡೆ ಕಳಿಸಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಅಲ್ಲೇ ನೀರ್ ನಿಂತು ನೀರು ತಿಂಗಳಾನ್ಗಟ್ಲೆ ಸ್ಟಾಗ್ನೇಟ್ ಆದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಮಳೆ ಬಂದಾಗೆಲ್ಲ ನೀರ್ ನಿಂತು ನಿಂತು ನೀನ್ ಬೆಳೆ ಬೆಳೆಯಕ್ಕಾಗುತ್ತ?
ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್.
ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ನೀರ್ನ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೀರು ಇಂಗ್ಬೇಕು, ಮತ್ತೆ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಡಿಸ್ಪೋಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಹೊರಗಡೆ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕು ಆಚೆಗೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕಾಗಿನ ದಿಸ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಬಂಡ್ ಹಾಕ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ. ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತಾ? ಹಲೋ
ಸರ್. ಹಾ ಸರ್, ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತು.
ನೀನ್ ಕನ್ನಡ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ನೊಂದ್ಸರ್ತಿ ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ, ಕೇಳಿಸ್ಕೊ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ. ಸೊ ಗ್ರೇಡೆಡ್ ಬಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ನಾರ್ದರ್ನ್ ಎಂಬಾಂಕ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಅಕ್ರಾಸ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಲೋಪ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ ರೈನ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ದಿ ಸೇಫ್ ಡಿಸ್ಪೋಸಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾಗ್ನೇಟೆಡ್ ವಾಟರ್ ನಿಯರ್ ದಿ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಬೈ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡಿಂಗ್ 0.2 to 0.4% ಬಂಡ್ ಗ್ರೇಡಿಯಂಟ್ ವೇರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಏರಿಯಾ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ ಮೋರ್ ದನ್ 700 millimeter. ಡಿಡ್ ಯು ಗಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು? If you are not got it, I will explain once again with Bharatanatyam. Okay. So, Didier, the another one is, this is one, another thing, the graded body strips, this is one more the conservational measures. Here, just I will tell you brief, that the, I will come to the designing and also layout of these things. Today I will give you the just framework, that's all. You remember what the kind of the conservational measures for this purpose, this category of a land and this category of a land, that's all. Okay, graded border strips. Here what they have made, 150, so see here, 150 meter length with a width of 30 meter. So they have formation of small section bunds at every 30 meter width with a length of 150 meter. So bifurcating the land into a strips, bifurcation of the land into a strips, so that strips is provided the grain, what I already told you, that is 0.2 to 0.4% the grain should be provided for the small section bunds. Is it clear?
Yes sir.
Yeah, this if you have any doubt about this one, please. This is general description. I will explain in depth what happened in the after rain, that variation in the rain, and how that will be managing, adjusting, all the care will be taken, that will be discussed in the particular class. Okay, anybody? Yeah, please. Feedback? Chetan? MJ? Hemant MJ? Desha?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir. Yes, sir.
So the graded border strips are the strips are made. The land is bifurcated into a strips by making this construction of a small section bunds, providing grades, and they are constructed across the slope. Okay, I will explain in detail about the next class. Okay, in the particular class, I will explain. So this is how. Another one is the contour boulder bones. So whatever the locally, so see here, some of the situations, what happens, the locally available, the boulders are there, or the stones are available, plenty. So instead of going for, when there is a slope, more slope, so it is in that situation, so what happens, whatever the local available, the stones are pebbles, so that will collect it and forming a, what is that, the bund, the stone bund, boulder bunds. So in that situation, what happens, whatever the water that will be flowing from the upstream side to the downstream, that will be flowing, and also that bund, boulder bunds is obstructed and check the flowing water, and it will be stopped, and maximum water is to be, and maximum the soil, that water is carried along with the soil. The soil is to be that is checked there itself, and only the water after saturation, that water is to be moved to the downstream side. So this is the another type of conservational measures in the arable land. Okay. Any doubt? Yeah, tell me. Please. Don't hesitate. So today, no girl students is pardon, yelappa. Yeli. Hello? Somebody is asking something. Hello? Yaar kelidu gothagilla, Hemant? Hello?
Sir, Banu Kumar kelda anusute sir.
Yen keli, yaar kelta illa nan yen anta gothagilla.
Sir, by chance have you been, sir?
I thought, okay, well.
Sir?
ಹಿಂದ್ಗಡೆ
ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ ಅದು ರೈನ್ ಫೈಟ್ ಏರಿಯಾಸ್ ಗಳು ಮಾತ್ರ ಇರಿಗೇಷನ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಕ್ ಆಗಲ್ವಾ? ಅದು ಸ್ಟೋನ್ ಬಂಡ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾರಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸರ್.
ಅಲ್ಲ, ಇರಿಗೇಷನ್ ಬಂಡ್, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಪರ್ಪಸ್? ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅವರ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಶನ್ ಮೆಜರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ಆಫ್
ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಎರೋಷನ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಶನ್.
ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇರಿಗೇಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ವಿ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿ ಇರಿಗೇಷನ್ ಅಟ್ ಆಲ್. We are not talking about the irrigation at all. Yes. Irrigation nalli mathe illa, yake andre irrigation nalli conservation illa. You are flooding the irrigation.
Okay sir.
Alli idli whatever the rain, where there is a crop is grown under the rainfall, so you have to go for adapting this. Okay?
Okay sir, thank you sir.
Okay. So this is the another one is, so what happens presently, some of the areas, I mean the only the land is not in flat, so it is more of the hilly areas side. So in that situation, the need of growing of a crop, cultivating the land, so in that situation where there is the slope of the land is more than 25% slope, so the people are needed to cultivate that land. So in that situation, it is not safe for cultivating the more slopy land without any conservational measures. So that is why this conservational measure is to be adapted, bench terrace. I will explain how that will be one by one. I will explain in detail about the topic which is covered during the bench terraces. Okay, so this is the bench terrace. What happens here, there is a portion of the soil, so you can find it the number of plots here, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, here 8 plots. Did it's audible?
Yes sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Please feedback. Otherwise, so here you can find this number of plots. In each plot, what happens? So the ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಎ ಮೊಮೆಂಟ್. Okay, so this is what happens in each plant. Did you audible? Audible? Somebody is chatting.
Yes, sir.
Okay. This plant is there. So in each plant, half of the portion is cut because slope is there. So half of the portion is cut, and that whatever the cut soil, the cut soil is to be filled downstream and make it level in the hilly areas. So this is the principle which is involved in this. Okay, cutting and filling in the terraces or in the hilly areas to make the plots and to grow the crops. So there are many the three types of terraces. We will discuss one by one later on. Okay, did you understand the concept?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So this is how half portion is cut, and the remaining half portion is moved towards downstream and make it level. So the next half portion is cut and moved towards the downstream, making another plant. And then they move to the half portion is cut and move to the downstream side and make it flat, and again it will be making another. Like this, they have to go for making the plots in the hilly areas. Did you clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is in this way they have to cut and fill the soil. So this is the original. So whatever the here, I will show you. One second. See. This is the whatever the line we have drawn here. So this is the land surface. Okay. So okay, here. Okay. Yes. See here. This is the original slope. The slope of the original slope of the land. This is the original slope of the land. What happens? Original slope. And that means surface, soil, surface. Soil surface. So here, see, some half portion of this soil is cut. Okay, whatever the cut portion of this soil, it is filled downstream side, and make it leveled. See, this is the leveled plot. Did you clear? All of you, did you clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So here three types. I will explain, and also I will give you the detail, the designing, and also the equations in the that particular class. So today I will give you whole thing. So then I will take one by one. Okay. So this is a three kinds. One is the sloping outward and sloping inward and leveled. Bench terraces. Sloping outward, bench terraces. Sloping inward, bench terraces. Here, slope is given inward. Here, the slope is towards inward. And here, slope is outward. And this is one, the plat leveled these leveled bench terraces. Okay, I will explain where these different kinds of the bench terraces are to be adapted in different situations. I will explain in details in the particular topic discussion. Okay, so see here, this is the one. This is the clear now. See how making this and cutting and filling and formation of such a plots. So this is another one, is grassed waterways. So waterways are the paths or the channels which are created in the cultivated land, which are providing a gradient to flow the runoff water with a non-erosive velocity without eroding again, further eroding. So whatever the excess water is there from the plat, that is making a small channels, and that water is whatever the water stagnated in the plat, or the excess water is to be provide the passage for the moving towards the downstream. That method of by making the channels, so small channels, so that will help for the safe disposal of excess water in the given catchment area, and also to with a non-erosive velocity. This is the one structure what we have to adapted in the cultivated land. Is it clear? See here, in this way we have to provide the waterways. So this is the way water, we have to provide the way for water is to be moved from one plot to the another plot, or the downstream side where in the lower elevated place. Okay, is it clear, all of you? Is it clear? Okay. You have less than 1 minute. Is it possible to rejoin on 20 minutes or 10 minutes?
ಸರ್ ಹಿಂಗೆ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು ಸರ್, ಅದು
ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಆಗ್ಬೋದಾ?
ಹಾ ಸರ್, ಅದು ಆಟೋಮೆಟಿಕ್ಲಿ ಆದ್ರೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಆಗ್ತೀವಿ ಸರ್.
ಇಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ಆಟೋಮೆಟಿಕ್ಲಿ ಲೆಸ್ ದನ್ ಒಂದ್ ಮಿನಿಟ್ ತೋರಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೆ.
ಹೌದಾ ಸರ್, ಹಂಗಂದ್ರೆ ಆಗ್ತೀವಿ ಸರ್.
ಒಂದು okay, is it visible?
Yes,
okay. Yes sir, visible.
This is the one, the another conservational measure, that is stabilized grassed ways. So there are the three shapes we have to provide. One is parabolic shape, and another one is the trapezoidal shape, and also the third one is the triangular shape. We have these three kind, and we will discuss which is best and which is we have to provide in which soil. That will be discussed in the particular situation. So see here, this is the design of the trapezoidal waterways. So in this way we have to design. The B is represented the bottom width of the channel, and the small d is represented the maximum depth of water, and also the other capital D is the total depth of the channel, and 1:2, that means the providing the vertical and horizontal slope for the side slope for the channel, and small t is the maximum, the top width of the water level. Okay, the capital T is the width of the, that is total width of the channel, total width of the channel. Okay, so we can use this formula. Okay, we can use this formula so for finding the capacity, that is we have to know this the what the carrying capacity of this channel of that particular storm runoff water. Okay?
Clear? Excuse me, sir.
Tell me.
So what does Z represents?
Pardon?
What does Z represents?
What?
Z represent what, sir?
That is slope. This one, no. I will show you. Slope. This one, slope.
Okay.
Side slope. Okay? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. The second one is, that is designing of a, that is a parabolic water ways. If you want to go for parabolic, so actually among these three, parabolic is a very effective, because there is no further the erosion of the base of the channel. Again, because what happens, the continuous flow of water in the channel, that will affect the further scoring of soil from the bottom and also sides. So parabolic is, it will be somewhat the advantages over the other two types of grassed waterways. Okay, so here same thing. D is the maximum depth of water flow, small d, and big capital D is that is total depth of the channel, and small t is the the width of the water flow, flow of water. The capital T is represent the total width of the channel. Okay, so we have to use this formula. So calculate. So what is that? This one I will repeat once again. A is the cross sectional area. So if you want to say any measures, conservational measures, if you want to say any size, you have, that is the cross sectional area. So if you want to find out the cross sectional area of this parabolic, you use this formula. Okay. And so this P, what is that P? Anybody? What it represents? Yeah, tell me.
Perimeter.
Yes, wetted perimeter. It is?
Perimeter.
Wetted perimeter. Wetted perimeter, that is always in meter. You can, R is, what is that R?
Rate.
Pardon? Anybody? Already, I have explained in the offline classes. Yeah, I think all because of this tension of corona, you're forgotten. What is that? Anybody? Somebody? Chetan?
Radius.
Where is that radius today? No girls are replying. What is that R? Anybody? Yeah, tell me quickly. R. I have given this equation in the
hydraulic radius.
Hydraulic radius, sir. Hydraulic radius.
Very nice, Ankita. Very nice. Okay, that is hydraulic radius. Hydraulic radius, that is A by P, cross section area divided by your perimeter, wetted perimeter. The T, capital T, if you want to know, calculate while designing, the only the top width of the channel, that use that equation T into D, capital D by small d whole square. So if you want to the depth of width of the water flow, so that we have to calculate it, okay, using that equation. And this is the third one, triangular waterways. So what happens, this is not a more suitable one. So if you want to construct this one, even after some time, what happens, this triangular waterway, it is turned into parabolic one because of scoring of the soil from the bed. It will making some parabolic itself. Did you got it? Ankita, did you got it? Huh?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So if you are designing this triangular waterway, no? So there is a continuous flow of water in the triangular waterways. What happens, there is a, due to the velocity, so some of that water, the soil is scoring, and it will making, automatically it will make the parabolic one. Okay? So we have to use this formula.
Sir, one thing I want to ask, sir. In the last class, you have told, sir, said that all the watershed areas and micro, macro, and then you have told that all these conservational measures are required for that areas when wherever there is a more scarcity of water, which are not for irrigated land or something, sir.
Yes.
Right, sir.
Yes, tell me, what is your question?
This all rainfall, sir, that yeah. These areas where they receive rainfall, sir, then there is a more no management regarding the sir rainfall irrigation and all, sir. I want to ask that to rainfall. Manage and have the excess runoff to be disposed of. Then the scarcity of water points, sir, I didn't understand.
I didn't understand your sir, question. So that conservational measures for the irrigated area, irrigated area.
Yes, sir. Means sir, you told. So means conservational methods are required for irrigated land only. Not means whenever there is more scarcity of water. So you have told one point regarding it now.
Yeah, the conservational measures is required only for the which kind of what you have to conserve it in the land. It's land is, tell me.
Sir, means I want to ask, sir, means conservational methods are required for those areas also, na, where there is more scarcity of water or there is more irrigation, sir, regarding the rainfall and all, sir. That I want to ask, sir. Means no, where we are not.
Just a moment. I didn't clear your this one now. Yeah, tell me. So what you told now, Ankita? Yeah.
Sir, you may continue, sir. I'll ask later on, sir. You continue, sir.
No, I am doing something.
That one, sir. Type mad and say sir.
Okay.
Sir, I'll ask you later, sir.
So, you put a one this what is that? Comment on the chat box.
Okay, sir. Okay.
I will clear it. Okay. So I will clear it. No. So this is one. The another one is the another structure that is a param pond. I think where there is a rain more of rain water. So see here. So earlier what happens? I show you one this one. No. This is the grassroot water. You know. So where there is excess water is to be flowed. So if you want to utilize this excess water is to be drained out from the your area or your catchment area. So that water is to be stored in some place. So that needs some area. So that is why you have to go for making one dig out a pond to collect all such a water for the further purpose. So for that, what we structure is needed is param ponds. Okay, param ponds. So this param pond, the param pond is a structure where the excess water from the cultivated land is to be collected and stored and utilized for the beneficial purpose for the future. Okay. So I will tell you detail in the param pond. What the capacity is required, how to design, and also what the advantages, and also the what alternative uses, how it will be beneficial, what the direct benefits, what are the indirect benefits. Okay, all these things we will discuss. In this case, there are two types. One is parampan, that is a embankment type. So what happens in the embankment type? Just to put the embankment that is across the slope in the downstream side. Okay, the dugout pond is dugout below the surface of the earth soil, so to a depth of required depth. Okay, so that I will discuss what are all the design criteria, everything I will discuss one by one in the particular classes. Okay. This is the impounding type. See here, just to putting earthen embankment and to store that water. Okay, store that water. That will be, there are different components. I will tell you one, the inlet, outlet, and all the conduct is there, So how to collect and what the that all we will discuss. Okay. See here, this is the one way dug out one. Below the surface, the whatever the water that will be flowed and it will be collected, that water is to be reused for the further purpose. So I will explain in detail. Okay. This is on the plan of the dugout type. So see here, the inner square is the bottom of the parampan. Okay. The outer square is one top width. So you can just assume the inner one is the bottom of the pond and the outer square is the top one. You just look at that shape, that is a container. Is it clear? So just to see the inner square is a bottom of the pond, and if you are assume that, sorry, you can consider the top, the outer, the square is the top of the parampan. So that seems to be a bowl, is it not? So this is the plan of dugout type of parampan. Okay, clear? Any doubt? So I think I will stop for this this one. This is the cross section. So this is a stepped one. So there are two kind, continuously sloped one and a stepped one. So there are two kinds. We will discuss in the particular class. See here, this is the cross sectional view of a both pond as well as the embankment. So now what we call that bund is called as berm. Berm. I will explain in detail in the particular class. So whatever the soil is excavated from the pond, that soil is to be put by leaving a 1 meter berm. So formation of the bund all around the four sides. So is it clear?
Yes sir.
Okay, this is one, the formation or dugging of the parampan. So in this way they have to dug out and provide all the components. Okay, sir. Now, tell me
sir. Divya, KC Divya want to ask you something, sir.
Yeah, please.
Sir, we need lecture outline, sir.
Okay, I will send it, no problem. Okay, let's I will send it to that group or your CR, then you can collect it. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
So what today we have discussed only a few things. See here. So this is the one after. So I will explain what is this everything in the next future classes. Okay. Why they have to made like this? Say this is the formation of the bund and making the what we call it is a lining. Lining is the what is that? To control the seepage loss from the stored water. So this is the one technology we have to use and to avoid the seepage loss. The stored water is lost through seepage is to be controlled. Okay, see here. Okay. Yes. I think this is the last one. Okay. So here up to this, all of you, please listen. All of you, whatever the control measures we have discussed here for the which category of a land? Tell me, Divya, KC. Divya,
arable land.
Very good, very nice. So whatever the discussions, the conservation measures are discussed from last class to this class. Okay. So all are for the arable land or the cultivated land. Remember, cultivated land. Next onwards, we will discuss the conservational measures for non-arable land and also the drainage line treatments. So after completing this one, another one class, so I will go with, because if you have know the skeleton, then you can draw the required all, okay? Without knowing the skeleton, we cannot understand the concept. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Hello. Any doubt, you please ask me. So we will discuss the next conservational measures in the future classes. Okay. So any doubts about this one, please don't hesitate. You ask me, I will take the somebody is asking question, no? Midterm syllabus. So I will give you everything. No worry about this, all this syllabus. If you are no without knowing the concept, no concept, if you are taken all these things, they are not worthwhile to. So I will send it, no problem. Okay. So I will give you the lecture outline, and also I will give you the portion. If you want something, even the important discussions, don't worry. We will discuss the ultimately we have to at least know the concept. That's without ಏನೋ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಡ್ತು ಒಂದು ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಇತ್ತು ತಗೊಂಡ್ವಿ ಅದು ಮುಗ್ದೋಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತು ಡಮಾರ್ ಮುಗಿತ್ತು ಒಡಿ ಗೋಲಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋದು ಬೇಡ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತಾ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಮೈ ಇಂಟೆನ್ಷನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅಟ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ಯು ಗೋ ಅಟ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಥಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಟಾಪಿಕ್ ಸೊ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ರಿಕಾಲ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ few things, not all, one or two few things. Any doubts? Hey, please tell me. I will stop, I think. Is it clear? Attendance send maadu.
Aayt sir,
tovandini. 88 jana bandidare.
Okay. Aayt sir.
Bhavani yaka maatladta illavalla, Bhavani? Absent ivare ante kada.
ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತು ಸರ್
ದೀಪ್ತಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದಾರೆ ಹೊರಗಡೆ ಇದ್ದೀರಾ ಓಕೆ ಏನ್ ಕೇಳಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾ ಇದಾರೆ ಏನು
ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್ ಕೇಳಿಸ್ತಿದೆ
ಇದೇನಾಗಿದೆ ಅದೇ ಹೇಳಿದ್ನಲ್ಲ ಇದು ಏಕಪಾತ್ರ ಅಭಿನಯ ಮೂಕ ಪಾತ್ರ ಅಭಿನಯ ಮಾತಿಲ್ಲ ಮೂಕ ಅಲ್ಲ ಏಕಪಾತ್ರ ಅಭಿನಯ ಒಂದ್ಸತಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೇಳೋದು ಈ ಕಡೆಗೆ ಬಂದು ಕೇಳೋದು ಆ ತರ ಆಗೋಗ್ಬಾರ್ದು ಅಂತ ನನ್ನ ಅಭಿಲಾಷೆ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ರೀಸನ್ ವೈ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಆಲ್ ಅಮೃತಾ ಜಿ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತಮ್ಮ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ ಏನ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತಲ್ಲ ಕೇಳಿಸ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಲಿ ಅಂತ ಸುಮ್ನೆ ಈಗ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ನೋಡಿದ್ದೀವಲ್ಲ ಹುಡುಗರು ಆನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಮೂಲೆಗಿಟ್ಟಿರ್ತಾರೆ ಅದು ಮಾಸ್ಟ್ರು ಹೊಡ್ಕೊಂತಾ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ ನಮ್ಮನೆಗೆ ಕೇಳಿದೀವಲ್ಲ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತೀವಿ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಮೂಲೆಗಿಟ್ಟಿರ್ತಾರೆ ಇಟ್ ಕೆಳಗಡೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಉಪ್ಪಿಟ್ಟು ತಿನ್ನಕ್ ಬಂದಿರ್ತಾರೆ ಏನ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಿದೀರಿ ಅಂತಾರೆ ಇದು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಈ ತರ ಆಗ್ಬಾರ್ದಲ್ಲ ಕೇಳಿಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ಐಶ್ವರ್ಯ ಐಶ್ವರ್ಯ ಎಸ್ತಲ್ಲಮ್ಮ ಅದೇನೋ ಮುಖ್ಯಮಂತ್ರಿ ಅಲ್ಲ ಇದು ಸಿಎಂ ಸಿಎಂ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನಮ್ಮ
ಇನಿಷಿಯಲ್ ಸರ್
ಇನಿಷಿಯಲ್ ನಾನೆಲ್ಲ ಇದನ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟೆ ಏನು ಯಡಿಯೂರಪ್ಪ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೇನಮ್ಮ
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್
ಏನಾದ್ರು ಡೌಟ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಕೇಳಿ, ದಯಮಾಡಿ ಕೇಳಿ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್. ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ದೋಸ್ ಈವನ್ ದಟ್ ದಿ ಐ ಸಿ ಆರ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದೇ ಡೋಂಟ್ ನೋ ಈವನ್ ಇಫ್ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಟಾಕ್ ಇನ್ ಲೋಕಲ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್. ಸಮ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಐ ಐ ಯೂಸ್ ದಟ್ ವರ್ಡ್ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ವೈ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಸಂಬಡಿ ಈಸ್ ಆಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಸಮ್ ಇನ್ ಡೆಪ್ತ್ ದೇ ಡಿಡಂಟ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಟ್ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಸಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಸೊ ಯು ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಕ್ಷತಾ ಅಕ್ಷತಾ ನಾಟ್ ಅಕ್ಷತಾ ಅಂಕಿ ಸಾರಿ ಅಂಕಿತಾ ವರ್ಮಾ ಅಂಕಿತಾ ವರ್ಮಾ ಓಕೆ ಅಪ್ರೂ ಚಾಟ್ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ ಹೇಳಿ ಅಂಕಿತಾ ಪುಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ದಿ ಕಾಮೆಂಟ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಚಾಟ್ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್
Sir, what's the question?
You're asking some question.
Yes, sir. Sir, I'll ask in the next class, sir. I'll write my question properly, sir.
No, no, you put it in the chat box.
Yeah, yeah. I'll write in the chat box, sir. I can, but may I continue in the next class, sir, that question, sir?
No problem. You put it in this chat box. Okay? Mm-hmm. I will explain.
Yes,
I will explain next class.
Yes, sir. Okay. Okay, sir. I'll ask you next class.
Okay.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.